Hello guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. That textbook over there was one of the textbooks I used in a Nigerian law school, Kano Campus. So guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mary and I'm a practicing lawyer in Nigeria. On this YouTube channel, I film about my legal life, I share legal tips, and I also share legal lessons. Thank you to my new subscribers. Thank you for being a part of this YouTube channel. I'm super excited to have you. And to my returning subscribers, thank you so much for always coming back to watch my videos. And if you're yet to subscribe, if you're a law student, you're watching this video, you're in the law school, please do want to subscribe to this YouTube channel. I'll be sharing a lot of videos, a lot of tips to actually help you in a Nigerian law school. So please do want to give this video a thumbs up and also subscribe to this YouTube channel. So today in this video, I'll be sharing with you how to prepare for the Nigerian law school. If you're already in the law school or you're still preparing to go to the law school, please, this video is a must watch for you. So please make sure you watch this video till the end. Now, without further ado, how to prepare for the Nigerian law school. My law school was at Kano Bagada campus, and that was 2017, and I'm so excited to actually share with you a few tips to help you prepare for this journey. So first tips I'll be sharing is, please stay close to the campus. All the Nigerian law schools in Nigeria, they all have campuses. But if you are the type that you don't want to stay in the campus, please make sure you live very close to the campus. Imagine, my law school was in Kano, I mentioned that earlier, and it was in a village called Bagauda. So imagine if I don't want to stay in the campus, I may not get a good accommodation, a good apartment within that village of that Bagauda village. I may want to go to town. So imagine driving or taking a cab from town about 40 minutes, 40, 45 minutes away to school every day and evening. That will give me a lot of, that will not be good for me, honestly speaking. So if you're the type that you don't want to stay in campus, please, please and please, make sure you live close to the campus. But trust me, you may not get a good accommodation around there. So it is just better for you to stay in campus. But if you know you don't want to stay, make sure you live close to campus. You can't imagine driving or taking a cab from the law school to town, morning and evening. That time you're meant to be using it to rest or to read or do something more meaningful for that 1 year journey. So it is very important for you to either stay in campus, but if you don't want to, make sure you live close to campus. During my own period time in Kano, I stayed in campus and it was really a good time for me because that 1 year is just for me to actually focus on a particular thing. So I don't have any reason to start getting an apartment somewhere and start furnishing it. No, it's just a program that you are there and you have to live. So I don't buy the idea of you taking an accommodation out of the school, outside the school premises, not staying on campus. So that is number one. Number two, avoid or minimize distractions. When I say distractions, your business, your work, sometimes your relationship, sometimes, please, in quotes, I will share my own personal experience as relating to that, may be a distraction. And if you're married, you need to minimize distraction. Your marriage is very, very important. Your career is as well important, but you need to minimize distraction. One tip I think will help in this aspect is, in terms of relationship or marriage, you need to have a heart-to-heart talk with your partner. It is very, very important. No matter how you think your partner is, my partner, you will understand or she will understand, you still need to sit down, if possible, a physical thing, before you travel or before you embark on the journey for the Nigerian law school. You need to sit down and talk with your partner. My own experience in 2016, I was actually dating someone then. I was still in school and it was a difficult period for me actually, because I was just leaving school then and it was, so just so crazy. So I had to talk to a friend who is actually a senior colleague that, please, how were you able to actually do this thing? Because now that my relationship is even giving me headache as an undergraduate, imagine just going to the law school, and law school, I need rapt attention. So she advised that I should have a heart-to-heart talk with my partner. Though it didn't work and I just had to call this quits, yes, I ended that relationship before going to the Nigerian law school. I called it quits because I knew that that relationship would actually mess up with my mental health, mess up with my program for that period of time. So I'm not saying you should do that. I am not saying that. But my point is, you need to sit down with your partner, and if you're married or just a relationship, whatsoever, courtship, you need to sit down and talk to your partner. You need to make them understand that Nigerian law school is quite difficult from the law program we did in the university. If you're the type that you love to be on the phone with your partner for hours, my dear, that will not be possible in Nigerian law school. It may be possible for you, but talking for a long period of time every day may not be possible, honestly speaking. Kano campus, then we still have lecture, I think 9 to 4 o'clock, and by that time, you have to rush to eat, prepare yourself, wash, do some laundry and all that. You have time to make calls, but you don't have time to actually sit down and pick calls every minute and do these long conversations. It may not be possible. So in case your partner will start calling and be like, you don't longer call me, are you seeing someone else there and all that? So you need to sit down with them and make them to understand this is how it works over there. So it is very, very important. And in terms of business, my dear, I would advise you, if you have a running business, a running company, I would advise you to give it to a credible person to manage it for you for that period of time. And maybe on weekends, you can always call to know how things are doing over there. But that period, it is not advisable for you to say, okay, I'll be in Lagos campus, I can still be doing my business in Lagos, or I can still be going to office and all that. It may not be possible. It may not be possible. A big may not be possible. So please minimize distractions. If possible, avoid distractions. Your business, your work, give it to credible hands to do for you. And have a heart-to-heart talk with your partner. Number three, take care of your health. Yeah, I'm talking about your mental and physical health. Honestly speaking, you need to take care of yourself. You need to take care of yourself. You need to rest as at when due. I made that mistake during that period. I was like, I just want to study and nothing more. So I don't sleep well. At the point I was sick, I was rushed to the clinic and I was treated. I was quite okay. I had to go back to the hostel. And that particular night, I think the next day, I was like, guys, I was trying to talk to my roommates, like, come on, get up, let's go and study and all that. All I can remember was I got up from bed and I was trying to talk to my colleagues. And the next thing is, I just saw that I was on the floor. Even my colleagues, my roommates, they didn't get up from their bed to actually be like, Mary, what's up? What is wrong with you? They were all tired. So that would be my very first time in my life that I would think maybe I fainted or something. Very first time in my life. So you really just imagine that happening when we are having exams. Just imagine that happening when the next day is actually corporate law. So which means that particular night, I was just little hours. I couldn't study well because I just had to rest so that the next day I'll be so active to actually write, sit for the exam. So you need to take care of yourself mentally and physically. You need to rest as at when due. When you know, before you break down, once you notice your body that you're getting so exhausted, it's nothing bad not to study for that day. But that doesn't mean you take days from not studying. I'm not advising that. But my point is, please do well to rest as at when due. And number four, please. Probably when traveling to the Nigerian law school, or when you get to the Nigerian law school, please do well to get enough cereal and beverages. Honestly speaking, you need to do that. Nigerian law school, you can't own a stove or anything at all that you want to cook, any gas or anything. You cannot cook there. So everything you'll be eating there is to buy food, or when you have your cereal and beverages, you can always do that. Make that in the morning and take, because Kano campus, we don't have then. I don't know, probably now they do. There was nothing like seat number. So I love to have eye-to-eye contact with my lecturer. So which means I have to go to class early enough to make sure that I sit in the front. So most times, I can't go to Mami Market to get food. And Mami Market, I think their food used to maybe 10 or 11. So by that time, I'll be in class. So most times in the morning, I think it's everyone. What we do is to take cereal or beverages. So you need to have enough of that, because you can't be studying. People that love to sleep for 8 hours, then by that time probably you'll be sleeping for 5 or 6 hours and you're not feeling well again. No, double your body. So please, you need to actually eat well. So you need to have enough of cereal and beverages. Once it's finished, you need to buy. Then I used to buy one big milk then, so I just make sure that I eat very well. So afternoon, most times you can always go for lunch, but where our lecture center was or is till now to the Mami Market is quite far. So I can't imagine myself under the sun trekking for How many minutes? It should be up to 20 minutes. The place is quite, it's quite far to the market, and you have to start coming back to the lecture room. It's like I just felt I cannot do that. So in the morning, I take my beverages. In the afternoon, I used to have biscuit and water in my bag. So that is what I take. And when we finish class in the evening around 4, first, I think most times I'll just go to the market and get food. And from there, I'll go back to my hostel, to my room, freshen up and all that. So that is number 4. And lastly, I want to encourage you to be optimistic. There are a lot of stories of people that failed bar finals. There are a lot of stories of people that felt it is stressful. Honestly speaking, it's actually stressful. And I'm also of the opinion that that 1 year program should have just been like 3 years. And in the university, we just feel like 3 years in university and probably 2 or 3 years in the law school because it's actually bulky, honestly speaking. But be optimistic. If I can do it, you can do more, honestly speaking. So be optimistic, be encouraged. Just make sure you read, study well. 2, to be confident in yourself, you have to study well, and also you need to pray. So don't panic. I don't think throughout that period I did not panic because I was praying. I was studying rather, and I was also praying. So I did not see any reason. That is where the confidence comes. I did not see any reason why I should fail bad finals. Honestly, it's because I was studying and I was praying. So I was actually doing my part. So why would I fail? So do not panic and be optimistic. So please run with these few tips as you're preparing for Nigerian law school, as you're going for Nigerian law school, or you're ready in the Nigerian law school. Run with these tips, and I will actually come with more videos and bar finals, your stay in the Nigerian law school, and lots more. So please do want to subscribe to this YouTube channel. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have any question at all, if you have any thing on your mind that you want me to actually make a video on, please do well to put it in the comment section. I will attend to it. And also, I may be bringing a good friend, a senior colleague, who is actually a first class candidate. He had 2-2 in the university, but luckily for him, not even luckily, he actually worked for it. He had a first class in the Nigerian law school. So I may be bringing him on my YouTube channel to actually give tips for every law school candidate. Thank you so much, guys, for watching. See you in my next video. Bye.